of socialist society in Romania. According to a study drawn up by the World Watch Institute, in the first half of the 80s, the military spendings in the industrial countries went up twice faster than the economic growth rate. For instance, over 1980-1985, the growth rate of military expenditures in those countries was 5.7%, while that of the gross social product only 2.2%. One of the authors of the study said that the next generation would consider the illusion that national security can be maintained through the force of arms as a historic error. The capital city of the Soviet Union saw the resumption of the debates of the Congress of the People's Deputies of the Soviet Union. On Tuesday morning, the President of the Supreme Soviet, Mikhail Gorbachev, tabled a report on the main guidelines of the domestic and foreign policy of the Soviet Union. President Gorbachev said the military budget of the Soviet Union for 1989 is of 77.3 billion rubles, that is 124 billion US dollars, and he proposed its cut down by 14% for the 1990-1991 period. The NATO summit has come to an end in Brussels. The heads of state and government of the member countries finally reached the compromise formula in the global concept regarding the priorities of the North Atlantic Alliance in connection with the disarmament negotiations and arms control, which must guide the policy of the bloc in the next decade. It was agreed that the United States should develop a new short-range missile of the land type, with a specification that the decision on its manufacturing and location will not be taken before 1992. Moreover, acceptance in principle is given to the negotiations on nuclear tactical armaments, but as the document underlines, those will only be initiated after the conclusion of the Vienna negotiations on cutting troops and conventional armaments in Europe. The summit has also adopted a declaration on East-West relations. The proceedings of the first international conference on the settlement of the problem of refugees in Central America have started in Guatemala City under United Nations sponsorship. The conference is focused on the situation of the nearly 2.5 million refugees from Central American countries who, owing to the conflicts in the region, were compelled to leave their homes, taking refuge in various countries of Central America. After the debate, Javier Perez de Cuellar, UN Secretary General, called on the participants to find a practical solution to put an end to the sufferings of the refugees in that region. The scope of the problem, Javier Perez de Cuellar said, points to the acute political and social crisis in that region. Taking the floor in front of the deputies to the People's Assembly, the President of Egypt, Hosni Mubarak, stood in favor of the summoning of an international peace conference in the Middle East. He said that all sides concerned in the Middle East conflict and the permanent members of the Security Council should take part in this conference. He said that the settlement of the situation in the region should be based on the resolution of the Palestinian issue by implementation of the rights of the Palestinian people. And that's the end of our news.
May we remind you that this is Radio Bucharest, Romania. We now bring you a commentary on the humanistic character of Romania's policy. This characteristic feature of Romania's conduct in international life originates in the close unity between the domestic constructive activity devoted to multilateral progress and to the promotion of the supreme ideals of peace, independence, and progress of all the peoples. The deep humanism of this policy is eloquently embodied by Romania's actions, initiatives, and demarches to put an end to the arms race and for a transition to disarmament, to remove the nuclear danger which threatens human civilization. Its central element is the supreme right of people, of nations, to life and to peace. As President Nicolae Ceaușescu underlines, the struggle for man for the assertion of his basic rights means, first of all, to remove the danger of war, which under the present circumstances would turn into a nuclear conflagration with catastrophic consequences for the entire mankind. In such circumstances, all the other rights would be pointless in the absence of life. The problem of human rights would not be posed any longer. There would be neither people whose rights should be applied nor people to ensure their application. Romania's permanent efforts to peacefully settle by political means all disputes and controversial issues among states serves the same lofty goal. No matter how long, how thorny, or how difficult, negotiations might be, they are preferable to armed conflicts, which have always caused the loss of the most valuable asset, human life. By virtue of this conception, Romania, its president, stand and act for the amplification of and for the lending of an irreversible character to the steps made for the cessation of armed conflicts in various parts of the world, for the definitive extinguishing of all hostiles of tension and war, of all crises in the world, through the participation of the sides concerned in negotiations in conditions of quiet and understanding, thus established, and enabling our respective peoples to devote their energy to peaceful and constructive work. It is in the same humanistic spirit that Romania approaches the problem of underdevelopment, a painful phenomenon which condemns billions of people, over two-thirds of the world's population, to terrible suffering and privations, depriving them of the advantages of civilization. Humanism is incompatible with the ever more stronger division of the world into rich and poor, the polarization of wealth on the one hand and of famine on the other, of misery and illiteracy, in which huge masses of people are living, is a huge injustice exacerbated by the crushing burden of foreign debts. To put an end to this profound anomaly, our country has defined and promoted the concept of a new world economic order. The ample program of measures advanced by Romania is focused on the placing of economic relations on really new bases, which should lead to the bridging of the existing gaps, to the removal of poverty, to a more just and equitable use of the resources of our planet, to the unhindered access of all peoples to the gains of science and technology, and this way conditions being created for the fulfillment of the legitimate aspirations of progress of all the inhabitants of our planet. One cannot talk about humanism, President Nicolae Ceaușescu says, if one does not observe the inalienable, imprescriptible right of each and every nation to be full master over its destiny, to live its own life as it wishes, according to concrete conditions, without any interference, pressure, or interference from the outside. Real humanism calls for the complete elimination of the policy of force, domination and diktat, the placing of the principles of national independence and sovereignty, full equality of rights, no interference in the domestic affairs of others, and mutual advantage at the basis of the relations between and among all states, regardless of size, level of development, political and social system, apartness or not, to political military alliances. In the spirit, Romania has declared in all firmness against colonialism and neocolonialism, against the policy of racial discrimination, against any form of enslavement of the peoples. Romania has energetically condemned each and every time all acts of aggression against some independent and sovereign states, any manifestation of a nature to disseminate hatred and feud between and among nations. According to this comprehensive conception, in which the humanitarian affairs are regarded as being in close interdependence, with various economic, social, and political facets, also tackled are aspects pertaining to the affirmation of the human rights in each and every country. By rejecting propaganda humanism, which tries to bring to the fore marginal aspects and not what is really essential in the promotion of the human rights, Romania starts out from the need for the implementation, first of all, of the basic human rights, the right to work, to housing, to education, to health care, to a dignified civilized life. These are rights which, as shown by reality, are far from being implemented even in some of the most developed countries of the world. Romania suggests a set of measures meant to ensure equal conditions of work, of education, of health care to all members of society, the liquidation of unemployment, and an adequate training of the younger generation, the insurance of the necessary number of dwellings for the entire society, the liquidation of any discrimination and inequity, the full development and dignity and liberty of the human personality. It is in this way that Romania understands to constructively tackle the issue of human rights, and it is in this spirit that Romania wishes to cooperate ever more closely with all political and social forces all over the world. Peace, economic and social justice, access to a job opportunity, to good health and education, to housing, or as many targets, demanding conjugated and longer prospect efforts. This program is coming to you from Radio Bucharest, Romania. In our series featuring new towns on the country's map, today we present to you Dermănești.
A memorable event has taken place in the history of Birmanist County Baku this month. Under the recent law on the improvement of the territorial administrative organization of Romania, the former commune has become a town. That was sanctioned in the first session of deputies who elected the Provisional People's Council of the new town of Birmanist. The fact that the place now ranks among the urban settlements is the outcome of the implementation of the policy of the Romanian Communist Party and of the Romanian state of harmonious, balanced development of all localities and zones of the country, particularly since the Ninth Party Congress of 1965. This locality in Trotuș Valley has registered high economic and social growth rates. The investments allotted entailing a better turning to account of the local resources. It is the lapse of time during which an oil refinery and a thermal power station were put into operation at Birmanist. The Boiana Uzului Hydrotechnical Complex was built. The woodworking unit at Selituc was modernized. The coal mines at Lapoș were reopened. New crude drilling rigs were commissioned. In the ongoing quinquennium alone, the value of industrial production is close to 4 billion lei. As is only natural, the economic development of the locality has been accompanied by major changes in the social professional structure, in the residents' whole way of life. The inhabitants of Birmanist, formerly cattle breeders and woodcutters, are today oil workers, grillers, miners, power workers, petrochemical workers, electromechanics. The newly created jobs have also attracted to the settlement those who for years had been working in enterprises in other parts of the country. Thanks to its industrial advancement, Birmanist has got the look of a modern, ever more flourishing town with an ever higher living and civilization standard for those working and living in the place. The signs of urban civilization can be met with at every step, in the modern and comfortable residential quarters, in the technical facilities, in the shopping centers and service network, in the other social, cultural edifices erected in all these years. Birmanist now boasts 17 schooling units, 3 Sancta Romania centers of culture and creation, to which one more will add up, 5 cinema halls, 46 shopping units, medical units, etc. The picturesque scenery in the Uzu Valley is completed by man-made beauties. The storage lake, the dam, and the hydropower plant, the tourist halting place, and so on, all bestowing on the new town the well-deserved status of an attractive resort. The development and modernization of the locality will not be confined to these achievements. The urban landscape of Birmanist will be further enriched by new blocks of flats, an outpatient unit and a polyclinic, an industrial high school, and other major units. All this is evidence of the rich resources of the 14,000 residents of Birmanist in their continued effort for the economic and social upsurge of the young town in which they work and live.
In our series featuring new towns on the country's map, today we have presented to you Birmanist. response to Radio Bucharest.
Romanian civilization, world civilization. In the following, we present to you a summary of an article carried by the weekly Contemporanul under the heading A Better Understanding and Acquaintance by Culture, under the signature of Teofil Balaj. The observance worldwide of the Mihai Eminescu death centennial, an event which is written down in the big calendar of great events recommended by UNESCO for this year, will occasion a number of editorial initiatives which are useful for a better knowledge and understanding of our national poet, both in the country and abroad. Alongside Mihai Eminescu, for a great number of years now, well known abroad are also poets Tudor Arghezi, Lucian Blaga, Ioan Barbu, Elena Văcărescu, prose writers Mihail Satoveanu, Liviu Rebreanu, Zaharia Stancu, Panaiti Strati, playwright Ion Luca Caragiale, as well as many others. The dissemination of Romanian literature by translations started more than a century ago in France, Great Britain and Italy by anthologies of Romanian poetry. The tempo of this dissemination, as it were, was rather slow. However, it has become much faster in the last decade. A simple confrontation of names of writers and books who and which are truly representative for our literature, with a number of translations from Romanian literature, will show that the main names of our poetry and prose of the classical period are well represented. Despite all difficulties raised by a translation of a play written by Ion Luca Caragiale, his plays have been translated into many languages and are staged in many countries of the world, on stages of Vladivostok or Lima, Tampere or Sydney and Tokyo. Translations from the prose written by Satoveanu and Rebreanu to most outstanding Romanian prose writers have been released in many countries. Our matchless narrator, Ion Clanger, was studied thoroughly and his work was translated a number of years ago by Jean Boutière. In its turn, contemporary Romanian literature is also rather well known abroad. Plays written by Camil Petrescu, Mihail Sebastian, Horia Lovinescu, Victor Eftimiu, Aurel Baranga, Teodor Mazilu, Dumitru Radu Popescu, Paul Everac were translated and staged in many countries of Europe and other continents. Translations into schools of foreign languages have been released from the works of Zaharia Stancu, George Kalinescu, Marin Preda, Titus Popovic, Eugen Barbu, Fanush Nagu, and Constantin Soyu, all of them being prose writers. Romanian poets such as Mihai Beniuc, Maria Banuș, or Eugen Jebeleanu, as well as their younger fellow writers of poems, Nikita Stănescu, Marin Sorescu, Ioan Alexandru, or Petre Stoica, are also well known in a number of countries by translations made from their poems. Proof of the international prestige enjoyed by Romanian writers in the world are also many international prizes and awards granted to many of them. An explanation of this prestigious affirmation of Romanian literature in the world is not complicated at all. Romanian literature is open. It has been open for several centuries to all that is happening in the world. Better said, we have always been in a permanent dialogue with the great trends of thinking in the artistic domain, and thus we have always been in contact with the genuinely great universal values. We have assimilated only their spirit. We have not copied them at all, and then we sometimes used the spirits taken over from the great universal assets according to our own conditions and availabilities. It is this, we believe, that has given originality to Romanian writing in each of the stages covered from the very first literary attempts in Romania to the present-day books. With every passing stage, we have made our contribution to enriching the general substance of world literature. Humanism and patriotism are deep inside the soul of the Romanian people. Literary creation, a result of the work and creation of a nation, be it written in Romanian or translated into other languages, meets the need for a better understanding and acquaintance by culture.
Thank you. Radio Bucharest.
Here is an invitation for you all to take part in a radio contest. Do you know Romania? The contest is held in anticipation of the 45th anniversary of the victory of the Romanian Revolution in August 1944. You are invited to answer the following questions. What was the domestic and international significance of the anti-fascist and anti-imperialist revolution for social and national liberation which took place in Romania on August 23rd, 1944. Romania has obtained important achievements in all fields in the 45 years since the August Revolution. Name at least one of the major projects carried out in Romania in the last two decades. The Socialist Republic of Romania, President Nicolae Ceaușescu, carry on a sustained activity for the building of a world of peace and cooperation. Would you please mention the most significant initiatives put forward by Romania at an international level? Your answers should be posted not later than September 30th, 1989. The winners will receive prizes consisting in handicraft objects, LPs with Romanian music, art albums, sets of slides. We are looking forward to receiving your letters here at Radio Bucharest, Romania. Listeners in North America has come to an end. Let us remind you that Radio Bucharest transmits two daily programs in its North American service. The first is at 02 hours UTC on 15380, 11940, 11830, 9570, 9510 and 5990 kHz. And the second at 04 hours UTC on 15380, 11940, 11830, 9570, 9510 and 5990 kHz. With our thanks for listening, we invite you to send us your remarks and suggestions on these programs to the following address: Radio Bucharest, P.O. Box 111, Bucharest, Romania. And now, time for goodbye.